Hello, it's a big pleasure to have you as a VIP guest at Seven Hills International Film Festival. Please introduce yourself and tell us the beautiful story of how you ended up here in Pecs, all the way from Hollywood.
Well, my name is Carole Wells, and I am from Hollywood. I'm a real Hollywood girl. I went to Hollywood High School. And I ended up here actually through Anton, Troy, and Dan, because we were all together in a workshop and just had some great times, and they suggested I come, and here I am.
Is it your first time in Hungary?
It is, and I'm loving it. They're so nice here. The people are so friendly, and it's clean, and I feel very safe here, which I think is a real plus, because
especially these days.
That's what I meant. There's so many places where you're not safe to travel, and everyone's welcoming you. It's just wonderful.
Since you've been there to see lots of changes in Hollywood, lots of, you know, seeing the powers that be change, trends change, stars fade, new stars getting born, how would you describe the evolution of Hollywood during the years of your professional career? Does it change for the better? Does it change for the worse? Did the new century change much or nothing?
Well, I think it's changed tremendously. When I was working, it was a much smaller group of people. And once you get established, I didn't even go out for casting. They just call me and say, would you like to do this? Would you like to do that? Now you go in and meet somebody and they're about 14 and they don't know who you are. And it's very strange. The actors themselves have gotten too political. They're very disrespectful. I'm very disappointed in how so many of them are acting. And they're very tacky, I'm sorry to say, but I think that it's a new breed of people that are not the quality that they used to be in their own self-respect. You know, there are a few that I really like, but most of them, I'm really disappointed in how they act privately and then how they talk publicly.
And I think the idea of what a movie star is has gone through so many changes. So nowadays, even I, as a journalist, a lot of times don't understand if it's an actress or she's a model or, you know, she's a social elite. So I think back in the day when you were starting, you know, you knew exactly what a movie star should look like, what kind of qualities she or he should possess. But nowadays, yeah, it's all mixed up. So essentially, it made it seem like it's easier for anybody to become a star. You don't have to look, you know, drop dead gorgeous. You don't have to, you know, have this presence about you. So do you miss the good old days when, you know, you actually had to walk into the room and every neck would snap because they were looking at you? Do you miss that era?
You know, it's true, because like my idols was Grace Kelly and Sophia Loren and Deborah Carr. And, you know, they were ladies and they were beautiful people. And it's true, we used to all dress up, and at night we'd go out in gowns and furs and jewels to just go nightclubbing. And it was exciting because you turn and you see somebody that you admired and there they were just looking beautiful. Now it seems that everyone wants to dress down and be as slovenly as they can be. And it's disappointing, it really is. I went to the opera the other night and it was an opening night and I was in a long gown, and the man sitting next to me was in torn jeans and go-aheads. And I'm thinking, you know, there should be some respect for what they're going to. It takes a lot of work to sing and put on production. By the way, wasn't our production last night fabulous?
Absolutely.
The symphony was glorious.
Absolutely beautiful. Yeah, Bahraini composer coming to Pecs,
yes,
and impressing the Hollywood star.
That's
a good story.
Because, you know, I used to sing opera. And in listening to the music that he made, there's such beautiful melodies. And a lot of the newer composers, not for the movies, but other ones, always make this wild, crazy music that you can't go home humming.
Exactly, you know? Yeah, it's all about the melody. I want to reverse back a little bit to what you were saying before, because you mentioned an interesting word, respect. And in the last couple of years, especially, there has been a huge talk about women in the industry of Hollywood. getting, talking about how they deserve much more respect, whether it's, you know, better pay rate or just, you know, the ability to feel safe while working with this
movement.
Man.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think about this? Because you've been in the industry for a long time. You've seen all the changes. But I feel there's something to be said that, you know, the classic Hollywood stars, they may have looked like babes, like you certainly did, but they had this power of beauty, which was unquestionable. So was it always like this? Do you feel like females in Hollywood, actresses always had some sort of power? Or you think it's something that's only developing now and there needs to be more of that? And I know it's a very deep and, you know, intriguing issue, but just to get your perception of this, because it's easy to be a starlet and, you know, jump on a bandwagon without even understanding what you're fighting for. But you were actually, you know, you've seen things happen. So what do you think about this? What actually needs to be done in terms of, you know, acceptance and equality in Hollywood?
I think the most important thing that women should be doing is, one, they shouldn't dress where they're half naked. And second of all, stand up for your rights. I've had the Me Too movement. I mean, my goodness, it's been going on for years that men were having sex with the girls and saying, we're going to give you this part if you do it, or if you don't do it, you won't get the part. And I had that happen to me on three really major occasions. And when the man was propositioning me, I said, I thought you were hiring an actress, not a prostitute. And another fellow, when I was at MGM Studios and he had taken over the studio, and we knew him socially, and he basically was saying, well, your contract is up for renewal and we'd love, you know, you to be again with MGM team. I was their Deb star. I was with them under contract working all the time. And he says, I want you to be cooperative. And he kept using the word cooperative.
Which is, yeah.
And I thought it meant be on time, know your lines, you know.
Well, it is.
Be professional.
But in the Hollywood dirty dictionary,
well,
lingo
I didn't
world.
Know what he meant. I was just 18, barely, like 17 and a half. And I said, Of course I will, thinking that he meant something else. And then he got up from the back of his chair and walked around and rubbed his hand against my breast. And then I just sat there in shock. And I realized what he was saying the whole time, being cooperative. And he told me some other actresses that were under contract were cooperative and would go out with one of the main backers and things like that. But I never got it until he did that. And then I just kind of froze. And then I just got up and I was stuttering. I just said, I don't think I'm going to be able to work here, and walked out. And I've had things like that happen, and I stood my ground. I wasn't going to go to bed with somebody for a job because I knew that I could get a different job. And the girls have to have more confidence in themselves and know that they have something to offer and not just lay down for anybody that promises them something. Nowadays, the girls go to bed with men without even taking them to dinner. I mean, it's gotten it's really not cool.
Because, yeah, there's a lot of jobs, even in Hollywood. So if, you know, if that particular job requires you doing something which you stand against, you can say no, right?
Well, I didn't even do nudes. And I had several pictures offered me, but I had to be nude. And twice Playboy magazine, this is when it first started, and they wanted me to be, they said not completely nude, but like a nightgown that you could kind of see through and things like that. And I wasn't interested in that at all. And I really was thinking, because I was brought up very strictly in my home, but the other part was, I thought that maybe I would have children one day, and if I did that, they'd be embarrassed. So I had a luncheon, and I had several of the girls, Linda Evans and Ursula Andress, and a couple others that were in the magazine, and they had their magazines all laid out. And my sons were in high school, and they came in and said, oh, Mom, that's cool. Why aren't you in it? And I said, well, I just didn't feel like I wanted to be nude in front of everyone, and wouldn't you be embarrassed now going to a Catholic high school if your mother was in a magazine like that? No, Mom, that would be terrific.
So you ended up not doing Playboy?
No. No. And they offered me a lot of money.
Well, you know, maybe they'll, you know, maybe they'll come back after the interview.
Oh my God. No one wants to look at me now. I mean, it's different, but it's just amazing. I think it all starts within yourself, and people that have their own dignity and their self-esteem won't do that and will just know that that's not for me. And that's how I was always guided in my career and in my life. I picked the person, they didn't pick me.
And that's how it's gonna be. So hopefully you'll pick the festival next year and come back, maybe bring a new movie or
a
new book.
I have a movie that I'm making right now, and a short film. And so I'd love to submit it for next year.
That would be amazing. Yeah, we're gonna keep our heads up and, you know, eyes open.
Yes.
Thanks for coming and gracing us.
Well, thank you. And you're one of the wonderful people I've met on this trip. You're adorable. Thank you.
Thank you. Take care.